In previous class, we studied voltage standing wave ratio. VSWR is defined as the ratio of maximum voltage to minimum voltage on the line having standing waves. Standing wave ratio is denoted by S, which is equal to 1 plus mod K by 1 minus mod K. So this is the standing wave pattern on the transmission line. This solid line represents voltage standing wave pattern, dotted line represent current standing wave pattern. Whenever voltage is maximum, current is minimum. Here x is equal to 0 represents source N. This is, take here x is equal to L, that represents load N. At load N, here voltage is maximum, current is minimum. The distance between current minimum and voltage minimum is lambda by 4. This is voltage maximum, this is current maximum. The distance between these two maximum values is also lambda by 4. Similarly, the distance between voltage maximum and voltage maximum is lambda by 2. Next concept, short circuit transmission line. Here load impedance ZR is equal to 0. If the transmission line is terminated with short circuit, then the line is called short circuit line. This is transmission line which is terminated with the load impedance ZR is equal to 0, that is short. Whenever load is short, the voltage across the load is 0. Short circuit transmission line. E ZSC represent input impedance of short circuit transmission line. The input impedance of short circuit transmission line can be obtained by substituting the ZR is equal to 0 in the input impedance of general transmission line. The input impedance of lossless transmission line Zn is equal to Z0 into ZR plus Z0 tan H gamma L by Z0 plus ZR tan H gamma L. This is for general transmission line. For lossless transmission line, this term becomes JZ0 tan beta L. You may take anything, no problem. Now substitute this ZR is equal to 0, then this is 0, this is also 0, then Z0 cancel. So input impedance of short circuit transmission line ZSC is equal to Z0 into tan H gamma L. If ZR is equal to 0, then input impedance of short circuit transmission line ZSC is equal to Z0 into tan H gamma L. This is for general short circuit transmission line. The input impedance of short circuit lossless transmission line. Whenever line is lossless, then alpha is 0, then gamma is equal to J beta. So for lossless transmission line, substitute gamma is equal to J beta. In this tan H J beta L becomes J tan beta L. Then input impedance of lossless short circuit transmission line ZS is equal to J Z0 tan beta L. Remember, tan H J beta L is equal to J tan
beta L.
The reflection coefficient of the short circuit transmission line is K. K is equal to minus 1. What is expression for reflection coefficient K? K is equal to ZR minus Z0 by ZR plus Z0. Now substitute ZR is equal to 0, 0, 0. So Z0, Z0 cancel, then you are getting minus 1. K is equal to minus 1. So reflection coefficient of short circuit transmission line is equal to minus 1. The VSWR of the short circuit transmission line, S is equal to infinity. What is formula for S? S is equal to 1 plus mod K by 1 minus mod K. So here mod K is equal to, in this case mod K is equal to, is equal to 1. Therefore 1 plus 1, 2, here 1 minus 1, 0, hence this becomes infinity. Next, the variation of input impedance of lossless short circuit transmission line is shown in below figure. The input impedance of lossless short circuit transmission line ZSC is equal to J Z0 tan beta L on y axis. On x axis take beta L for different lengths of the transmission line. On x axis we are taking beta L, which is phase difference. For example, if length of the transmission line is lambda by 4, then what about beta L value? You can write beta is equal to 2 pi by lambda. L represent length of the transmission line. Here length of the transmission line is lambda by 4. Now substitute L is equal to lambda by 4. Lambda, lambda cancel. 2 ones, 2 twos, which is equal to pi by 2. So if length of the transmission line is lambda by 4, then beta L is equal to pi by 2. Similarly, if length of the transmission line is lambda by 2, then beta L is pi. Beta L represent phase shift. So if beta L changes from 0 to pi by 2, then the length of the transmission line, in this interval length of the transmission line is lambda by 4, then the short circuit transmission line has only reactance. If this reactance is positive, then it behaves as inductance. So in this interval short circuit transmission line behaves as inductor. Why? Means its input impedance is a positive reactance. In second interval, when phase shift changes from pi by 2 to pi, then length of the transmission line is greater than lambda by 4 and less than lambda by 2. Lambda by 4 means quarter wavelength, lambda by 2 means half wavelength. During this interval, tan is negative and its reactance is negative. When reactance is negative, it acts as capacitor. So similarly, it repeats. Inductor, this is capacitor. So variation of input impedance of lossless short circuit transmission line. If length of the transmission line is less than or equal to lambda by 2, then it acts as inductor. If length of the transmission line is greater than lambda by 4 and less than lambda by 2, it acts as capacitor. These are the standing wave pattern on the lossless transmission line. This solid line represent voltage standing wave pattern, dotted line represent current standing wave pattern. For short circuit transmission line, at load ZR is 0, hence voltage is 0. The current through the short circuit is maximum, hence current here is maximum. For lossy transmission line, the amplitude decays like this when wave is moving from source end to load end. Voltage and current distributions on short circuit transmission line. First one represent lossless transmission line, second one lossy short circuit transmission line. Open circuit line. In open circuit, load is open. That means ZR is equal to infinity. If the transmission line is terminated with open circuit, then the line is called open circuited line. This ZOC represents input impedance of open circuit transmission line. Here load is open, that means ZR is equal to infinity, not zero, infinity. ZR is equal to infinity. Whenever load is open, current is zero. So open circuit transmission line. Similar to short circuit transmission line, the input impedance of open circuit transmission line can be obtained by substituting ZR is equal to infinity in the impedance of the general transmission line. The impedance of input impedance of general transmission line is equal to Z0 into ZR plus Z0 tan H gamma L by Z0 plus ZR tan H gamma L. Now substitute ZR is equal to 0. If you directly substitute ZR is equal to 0, this is infinity and this is infinity. Infinity by infinity, that is indeterminate form. So don't substitute ZR infinity directly. Before substituting ZR is equal to infinity, now take ZR common from numerator and denominator. Then these two cancel. Then this equation becomes ZR taken common means 1 plus Z0 by ZR tan H gamma L by this represent Z0 by ZR plus J tan H gamma L. Now substitute ZR is equal to infinity. So anything by infinity means this term is 0. Similarly, this is also 0. Then ZOC, input impedance of short circuit transmission line, ZOC is equal to Z0 by J tan H gamma L. So 1 by J is minus Z0. Sorry. Here no J term. Here there is no J term. Y means here there is no J. So here no minus Z0, simply Z0. Z0 by tan H gamma L means cot H gamma L. If ZR is equal to infinity, then input impedance of open circuit transmission line ZOC is equal to Z0 into cod H gamma L. Input impedance of the open circuit lossless transmission line is given by, for lossless transmission line, gamma is equal to J beta, then cot H cot H J beta L. Is equal to, here remember, which is equal to minus J cot beta L. Therefore, ZOC is equal to minus J Z0 cot beta L. This is the input impedance of open circuit lossless transmission line. Similarly, for open circuit transmission line, reflection coefficient is 1. Similarly, standing wave ratio S is equal to infinity. Y means same. So, take the formula for K, which is ZR minus Z0 by ZR plus Z0. Before substituting, ZR is equal to infinity. Take ZR common, then substitute. Then we are getting this is equal to 1. And now reflection coefficient is 1. Voltage standing wave ratio is infinity. Same variation of input impedance of lossless open circuit transmission line, which is minus J Z0 cot beta L, which is reverse of previous one. If beta L changes from 0 to pi by 2, in that interval, open circuit transmission acts as capacitor. If phase shift is greater than pi by 2 and less than pi, open circuit transmission acts as inductor. It repeats. This is the current voltage and current distribution on open circuit transmission line. At load, there is no current, so current is minimum. But for open circuit, voltage is maximum. This is for lossless line. For lossy line, this is the tendency. It decays like this. One more line, match transmission line. Already we know a line terminated with characteristic impedance Z0 is called matched line. For matched line, ZR is equal to Z0, hence reflection coefficient formula K is equal to ZR minus Z0 by ZR plus Z0. In this case, ZR is equal to Z0, hence this is 0. Reflection coefficient is 0. When reflection coefficient is 0, VSWR is 1.